We got to seek him. Not just in the pathway. Sometimes people ain't desperate enough. You know, you got some folks who want to approach God using intellectualism and big words. And, oh Lord, I know that thou art mighty and high above all the earth. That my situation is in your hands. And I give myself to you. And I'm going to wait on you, even though things aren't this and that. That's nice. Some people, they come to church, and they sit there, and they can't get their hair messed up. Give God some praise, but I can't get on odors or circles up under my clothes. I can't leave marks. I can't get undignified. I'm going to give God some praise. Because he's good. Yes, he's good. Ah, thank you, Jesus. People like that. They have to come in and put their Bible here. This has to be set there. This has to do this. And service is going to flow this way. And this needs to be done like this. And ushers make sure they have to do this and that. This is how they approach God. And others realize that they was blind. And they just glad to be in the house of God.
Amen.
You can tell them to get up, move their seat, go sit over there. I guess. Because God's over here like he's over there. You can tell them, get up, give God some praise, and you might have to tell them to sit down and stop. Some of you can't, some people can't mess with it. Because once they start praising, they can't turn it off. You know, and when you get into the point where you really are desperate, it changes your approach. Because people, you know, oh, please don't shoot me. You know, if you don't have a gun, please don't shoot me. They get that 45 pointed in their face. They be banging, hands, cries, screaming, snot, run out of nose, everything. Well, it's the same way with your soul. Your soul is at stake. That's what's at stake. And the consequences of being lost are so horrible that there's really not even adequate words to explain it. Just as though I couldn't explain to you how great heaven is and what heaven's like, neither can I explain to you how bad and how horrible hell is. The only thing I can tell you is make your calling and election sure. The scripture says, if the righteous scarcely be saved, where shall the ungodly and sinner appear? Now, if people who are living, doing all that they need to do, doing the right things, are barely saved, how much room does that leave for error? Or does it leave any at all? Is salvation so tight? Is that why the road is said to be so narrow? And yet broad is the way to lead to destruction, but this road we're on is so narrow. That tells me that means I gotta give up some things. Okay, you can't live and be saved if you're on a narrow road. If you ever been on a ship that's going down, I remember when the ship was going down with Paul. One of the things that they started doing was lightening the ship. Right? They started throwing food and weight and all kind of things off the ship. And you gotta realize that your soul is on this ocean, this storm, and it's this huge, big storm that we're in right now. And if you're going to stay saved, you're gonna have to lighten the load. There are some people you're gonna have to get out of your life. There are some things you're gonna have to get out of your life. There are some things on television, things you're watching, things you're saying, things you're doing, you're gonna have to let go of. You're gonna lighten the load. Yeah, you ain't gonna have as much fun in the flesh as you used to have. And that's what the problem is. Everybody wants to have fun and be saved. And sometimes that don't work. It's nice to be able to do all this and do all that, but it'd never be no point in me preaching just to make you happy. put my soul in danger.
Right.
If I just preach you to be happy and then deal with them and give you the truth. Man, tighten it up. We gotta tighten it up. And so when we begin to tighten up and do what God said do, then God will renew his covenant with us. He will. And I'll say this, there are people who can be in a bachelor condition and don't even know it. You don't realize it because it's so subtle. You get so comfortable. We were talking earlier about eating certain foods and my opinion on those certain foods. And folks are comfortable eating chitlins. I'm not. Because I know what they was packaging. I mean, I know it's all good, but I just can't eat them. Because if they smell like something wrong with how that tech go. But anyway, saints, there's something about the Holy Ghost. I can't explain it, but I got it. I want to open an altar for somebody who I want it, they don't have it. For somebody who needs prayer. For somebody who's dealing with issues and going through things. Or for somebody that's just seeking a closer relationship with God. And we want to open up for you to come down so we can pray for you.